สวัสดีครับ Good afternoon once again. Today is Friday, the 28th of May, 2021. This is the English language summary of the daily press briefing here at the CCSA. So first, thank you to Dr. Apisamai for the Thai language briefing just now. So firstly, she ended with something very important. Indeed, it's an infodemic that we're fighting here in Thailand and around the world. We seek to bring clarity to many issues as we can see in these past days and weeks in Thailand, and of course it's prevalent around the world as well. There's a lot of information flying around on many issues, many issues which are people are getting confused with. Now, here at the CCSA, we will try our best to address all of these unclear issues and make them clear for you as much as we can, as much as possible. It's something that happens in every sort of crisis. Every crisis has its own confusion mode, of course, with many messages coming out and overlapping and things like that. But we'll try our best. We'll continue to try our best to make Thailand stronger. And that's what Dr. Apisamai ended with just now, about making Thailand stronger with Thai people here and our foreign friends in Thailand. Let's just hope for the best and try our best, continue trying our best. Now, just one issue that you might have seen in the press yesterday and today. I'd just like to address an issue just in principle first, that of course there are many variants in the world right now in terms of COVID. It is actually not correct to attach a name of a country with a particular variant, meaning to say when you read in the press and you hear the word the XX country variant, you know, you've read that quite often. It's also in the television as well. It's something that people are kind of used to now. Actually, it's not actually how shall I say, politically correct, because each variant is not identified with any particular country per se. The correct way to use these terms is to say that they are COVID variants first found in XXX country, or first detected in a particular country. And of course, with the scientific code, the number that we have, B point, whatever digit that we have for each variant. I believe there are around 5 or 6 variants around the world right now. So the correct way to address that is to say that they are variants first found or first detected in a particular country, rather than using the name of that particular country to describe the variant itself. Of course, these variants, they are not necessarily originating or having the nationality or affecting the nationality of one particular country only. So the best way to address this, as I mentioned, is the variant first found in whatever country, variant first detected in whatever country. It is not variant originating from any particular country, or variant that comes from a person of a particular nationality. So hope that is clear. Just in principle, when you read news, global news from around the world in the past days and weeks. So I'll start off first with the new confirmed case, the number that we record for today. We're a good number in terms of recoveries. 4,044 new recoveries recorded for today, over 4,000 recoveries. However, we have a new confirmed case at 3,759, as you see on screen. And out of this number, 2,447 are cases of local transmission, 18 are cases of those from overseas infections, and 1,294 are within prisons in Thailand. Now, just on the overseas infection, just now, Dr. Apisamai, in the Thai version, every day we would lay out the number of people who have been infected with COVID, those coming in the country through flights or by sea. And we would have the nationality and the age and then some details of those cases on screen for you. Now, in the English version, we don't have that in detail because of we have less limited air time, of course. But in general, mostly the cases that we have would indicate whether they are Thai or foreign nationals. If they are foreign nationals, of course, there would be two cases. Firstly, that they enter the country through the legal means, the correct pathway or schemes, or they are in a particular exempt group flying in. So for the second group would be those who are entering the country illegally through natural pathways, which the security enforcement authorities are being very strict on these issues. So in detail, we have those coming from overseas infections, from where they are coming from, what nationality, what status, or the means in which they enter the country. So that's very good in terms of detail. Now, we have recorded new fatalities at 34 today, unfortunately. So our condolences goes out to the families of the deceased. Every day we report numbers, but these numbers are just not just numbers for us. One number is one life, as we had mentioned. The cumulative number of fatalities in Thailand are now 954, as you see in the red box on the right on screen right now. Now, the overall situation for COVID now remains kind of stable nationwide, stable but increasing nationwide, with clusters of infection found throughout the country, mostly from active case finding. The areas of concern are still fresh food markets, packing and electronics factories, large wholesale markets, construction workers campsites, informal settlements, and also, of course, border area arrivals continue to be a contributing factor in the overall nationwide infection. Overall, we have tallied today 59 provinces which are categorized in the white and in the green category. Just now we had a map of Thailand on screen for you. The white category is that to date we have zero infection in that particular province. The green category is that we have 1 to 10, only 1 and up, at least 1, at most 10 new infections in that particular province. That would be the green provinces. So white provinces and green provinces added up, today we have 59, which is a very good number in the provinces. Of course, in Bangkok, where this hotspot, that remains an issue in the various clusters that we have around Bangkok. Now, risk factors in general remain the connection, the intermingling of large crowds for long periods of time, contact with workplace and amongst family members or colleagues who are COVID positive. And for the ongoing efforts to curb the spread, we have the pooled saliva CPR tests also continuing to be conducted all across the country in every district and all markets within the Bangkok metropolitan area as part of the ongoing active case missions by 52 disease control teams all across the Bangkok area. And just to note, in terms of the statistics, you might have noticed that today the number of new recoveries has topped the number of new confirmed cases. As for vaccination, Dr. Apisamai mentioned just now about the vaccination distribution. Of course, we continue to distribute according to the vaccination plan. And to date, we have in the first dose of vaccination, the breakdown of the first dose is 34% would be the doctors and medical personnel, and 38% would be those in risk provinces and risk areas, such as those who are in provinces that are bordering our neighboring countries with border trade, like the province of Ta, for example. That's one risk area province. Bangkok, needless to say, and other provinces that had a lot of clusters in the past or continue to have a risk of clusters, such as Samut Sakhon and provinces which are surrounding Bangkok. So that's in the 38%. And then 34 is the doctors and medical personnel. And the rest, of course, is those under the criteria for the first dose, those who have underlying illnesses, and the elderly and the like. So that's for the first breakdown of the first dose. And the second dose will be quite similar as well. Now, the aim, as we mentioned quite often, I'll repeat that again today, that the aim of Thailand is ultimately by the month of September, we will have vaccinated the majority of the population, or 70% of the entire population, both Thai nationals and foreign nationals, those who are on Thai soil, 70%. Now, in terms of each province, they'll receive the vaccines, and the target for each province is actually to target 70% of their own population in the province as well. Aside from those provinces who are in a special case, who have higher risk, who are in provinces with high risk, a high risk situation, and the like. So minimum would be 70% of the entire population of each province. That would be translate into 50 million people in Thailand. 50 million people. Right now, of course, it's minus children and those and those who are expecting, because the vaccines at the moment we are not having the ones which are able to vaccinate children and those who are expecting. Now, 50 million people would mean 100 million doses, and according to our vaccination plan, that would be the target in our procurement. Just some additional information for you. Firstly, the field hospitals. Some of you might be wondering, how do we address the needs of the disabled, for people with disabilities, or those differently abled, those differently abled. So special field hospitals for disabled persons are also in the plan to be opened very soon. The field hospitals, this field hospital has been constructed at Sirinthorn Science Home in Pathum Thani province, and it aims to accommodate asymptomatic to mild symptom patients. It's a 224 bed hospital, 200 plus beds, and it will open its doors on the 1st of June, which is next week, and it will be able to cater to those who are disabled. This special field hospital intended to serve people with different types of disabilities, because it is equipped with special facilities such as remote controlled carts to deliver items to patients, the UVC sanitizers, and other assistive devices for the deaf, for example, for those who are deaf, for example, and of course negative pressure stretchers as well. Just one side information on disposing masks properly. We're wearing one-time use masks, most of us are, on a daily basis. It's important to remind ourselves how to properly dispose of masks to avoid further contamination. So first, take off the mask by pulling on both sides of the strings without touching the inside of the mask. Then fold the mask with the side touching the face inside, you know, inverting it inside, to prevent the spread of the infections. And of course, wrap the strap around the mask and dispose of it in a tightly sealed package, properly marked, to suggest that it contains contaminated waste. And you have an infographic there up on screen for you. So basically, this is the information that I have for you today. So thank you very much for your attention. The coming weekend, I hope that it will be time for all of us to sort of like adjust ourselves even more. Firstly, in terms of the infodemic that I mentioned at the beginning of this presentation. The infodemic, of course, is very serious. We have a lot of things going on social media that we read every single day. Some are true, some are false. I would say the things that I receive, around 70%, are not proven or not false. But of course, with the sheer excitement in terms of receiving new information, people tend to forward it to friends too quickly, you know, too quickly, without even reading it, without even reading or making sure or verifying such information. And of course, in this day and age, there are people, unfortunately, who bank on those who don't read information that thoroughly, and they produce fake news which are easy to misunderstand, and they forward it quite quickly on a daily basis. At least in Thailand, that's what's happening. So perhaps when we have time, we have a minute, I suggest that we all can sort of like look into the messages that we receive and see if it's actually just for the shock effect, or is it just for people to get excited with the news? Is it intentionally made for people to misunderstand misinformation? Is there any underlying intention that is not in terms of providing the correct information to people? Is it information which is aimed to discredit society or the country as a whole? Now, things like this happen. All in all, we are open to comments and suggestions. We recognize that in a crisis such as COVID, nothing is perfect, you know. We have to be flexible sometimes. Sometimes we have to adjust a lot of things. There might be some misunderstandings. And there might be people who might want to make use of that gap, you know, and of that risk that people have in terms of consuming news for their own benefit. So I think it's very important. There might be news yesterday or today regarding some things which affect Thailand. I recommend that all of us, including myself, read into it first and see how we can help make the situation better, how we can make Thailand stronger, how we can contribute to all of this society in Thailand, all of the issues we're facing together in the most constructive way possible. And with that, we thank you for your attention, and we'll see you again over the weekend. สวัสดีครับ